Michael Hartigan was a university dropout who was fascinated with the Hare Krishna movement. He married Janet Hartigan, a radiography technician who, by careful investment, had built up a small property portfolio. She too became committed to Krishna consciousness. The Hare Krishna community had a farm near Kyogle in New South Wales where they undertook basic subsistence farming, but where they could also perform their devotional activities. Janet Hartigan purchased another farm not too far away so the Hartigans would have their own home but also be able to participate in the spiritual life of the community. Ultimately, she hoped that her farm might also become a Hare Krishna community. The main farm, however, was deeply in debt. There was a risk it would be closed down and sold off. Janet suggested that she donate her farm, which could be sold to pay down the debt. Janet and Michael were told that they would be provided with suitable accommodation on the farm. The Hare Krishna leaders weren't putting religious pressure on Mrs. Hartigan. Neither was she promised any spiritual benefits, so it's not a case of actual undue influence. However, it was pretty clearly an unwise and unusual gift. Mrs. Hartigan was essentially putting herself and her family into poverty. Where there is a gift from a religious follower to a religious organisation or leader, it will be up to the recipient, the religion, the stronger party, to show that the gift was made without undue influence. They sent her along to a lawyer, but it was their lawyer, not someone independent. Beyond that, the Hare Krishna movement doesn't seem to have done much to really satisfy themselves that she had thought all this through. The court said making the gift was an enormity, quite outside the range of benefactions which a person could be expected to make, either according to ordinary community standards or according to the philosophy taught by the Krishna consciousness movement. This should have been obvious to anyone. It would be altogether unconscionable for the defendant to rely on the validity of the donation, and a court of equity should set it aside. This case gives us an example of presumed undue influence between religious leader and religious follower. The presumption was that the gift was the result of undue influence, and the Hare Krishna movement was unable to prove otherwise. The gift had to be returned.